This is just a little brainstorm I had on a possible way to do DFN and QFN parts using solder paste and hot air. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to put a little bit of paste on the thermal pad area here. Any excess should theoretically get sucked into those vias, so that ought to do it for that. I have my little chimp here. I'm going to put it down right there. Okay. Try to get it maneuvered into prestision. Okay, that looks pretty good. Just got to go to the left a little bit. That way. Now, luckily, this one here, we can see once we decide we're happy with where it is. Everyone should have a pick-and-place machine. See, we're learning new things here. Now, let's see here. We should be able to see our pins from the side to see how well we have done. Oh, look at that. It's perfect. Look at that. Doesn't look like any paste has squeezed out there either, does it? It looks fairly good. Yeah, that's pretty good. Alright. Now hopefully that excess paste, if there is, actually, that's about how much paste you would get on that center pad with the stencil, really, if we had a stencil, such a thing there. Alright, now here's my idea. So far, this has pretty much gone the way the other tutorials I've seen have gone. If you're paying attention, I didn't put any paste on the pins. Now, this is my idea. I'm going to take this paste and apply it now, afterwards, see? We're going to just put it right here. Okay. And then we're going to turn around. We're going to do the same thing on the other side as we did on the first side. Because side A and B should be the same, right? Alright, so what now? We're going to take our paste and we're going to take a little like credit card type of thing here. I'm going to push that paste up onto those pins very carefully, hopefully without disturbing our chip. So we're going to do this right here. Just very careful. I went too far. It's okay though. That's okay. No, it's not sticking to that one pad, so. Right, they're pads, they're not pins. I keep calling them pins. Can you tell I'm old school here? Okay. Now look at that, see? Now all of our, well, that one pin didn't get it, so the one on the end. So let's try moving our solder paste over here to the end and getting this pin on the pad on the end here. See, I keep calling them pins, but they're not pins, they are pads. They are freaking pads. Actually, the surface tension is kind of moving the chip a little bit, but so far we're doing okay. Alright, so now we have paste. It's not between the chip and the board, it's just kind of like off to the side, but it's on the pads. So now we're going to turn around because I'm right-handed. I have to do this right-handedly wise here. Now we're going to do it on the other side. That went much easier than the first side. Okay, now this is my little brainstorm here. Now that solder, when it flows, when we do the reflow action operation here, It's going to flow under that chip and hopefully solder that chip in there. Okay. Now I have another board, and we're going to do that one the normal way, where we put the solder paste on the pads first, on all the pads, and then drop the chip on there. And we're going to see which method works better, is more advantageous. Okay, now here's my other board, and I tell you, I don't have a high degree of confidence in this method. You know, I've seen other people do it this way before, but I don't know. I just have the sinking feeling that I'm going to get solder bridges underneath this chip here, but I don't know. We'll give it a try. This is our, I guess you would, what you would consider the control group of our experiment here. It's just, we have this other circuit board that's done using a more traditional method, and we'll see which one turns out better. And I'm just gonna go ahead and populate the board, put the chip on there the same way I did the other one. Okay, so I just got done reflowing these boards, and we already are starting to see some results of our test here. Now here is the board that I did with the new technique, and you can see that there's a few solder bridges there, just because there was a little bit excess solder on there that allowed those pins to bridge. Now that's, and now here is the one that I did using the other technique. Now you can see that there are no solder bridges on this one, at least not that you can see. But what I'm worried about is underneath the chip, that some of the solder could have been trapped under there. And also, if you look at that one pin, I keep calling it a pin, I just did it again. At one pad, you could actually looks like there wasn't any solder on it. Yeah, it looks like that one pin is completely dry. You know why? Yep, look at that. So, yeah, a couple of the bridges will have to be cleared out. And that's really not a problem, you know. Like I say, it's this other board where I could have possibly trapped some of that solder underneath the chip here that I'm more worried about. Because that's not something you can just take a soldering iron and clear out, you know. You would actually need to remove the chip and redo it. So I'm going to clear out these bridges here. And then, well actually before I do that, I have my little beep buzzer here. And I have these really fine little probe tips on it. And I'm going to just probe a couple of these pins and see if we have any solder bridges that we can't see here. So if you notice, I also left one of the components off of the board so that we could do this. So let's see here. This pin, this part here goes to this pin right here. Okay, we have continuity there. Oh, but see, look, that pin there, it's connected to it. It's connected there. That's supposed to be connected, though. I think it's actually, because this is a 200 milliohm resistor, so it's going to read as a dead short, basically, on either side of it. This other pad over here. Continuity. Yeah, that's beep buzzing there. Let's see, this one, that's the output there. Let's see, that one, no, that one. Okay. Yeah, those two are supposed to be connected. This one is not supposed to be connected. So if this one here beeps, we know we have a solder bridge. But it's not, see, so that's good. Okay. So far, so good. Alright, well, I'm going to clear the solder bridges on the other board. And then I'm going to do the same thing on that one. Sometimes it's just best to apply power and see what smokes. That's really the ultimate test. But since these chips are like, I don't know, these aren't exactly the cheapest chips in the world, so I don't really want to find out the hard way that I've done my wiring wrong. Okay, so I've cleared those shorts out on that other board. So, that board I'm going to call done because it looks really good now. Now, this was the board that I actually did using the more commonly used method and that had those pads that didn't have enough solder on them. So, what I did here was add a little more solder paste and kind of push it in there like the same kind of way I did the other one. Now see, the problem with this one was that I was so afraid I was going to get shorts underneath the chip that I didn't put enough solder on here to really flow all those pads. So I went and I did new method and put some solder paste in there, and I'm going to flow that solder paste now. And I went and removed that capacitor too because it was kind of in my way. And once I do that, we'll see where we are with this one. Okay, so here's our finished circuit board. And I can say this really turned out even better than I expected. So I can really recommend this new technique for anyone that needs to do some DFN or QFN without a stencil. Just take your squeegee or your credit card or whatever you're using and push that paste up onto those pads. And if there's a little excess, don't worry. If there's solder bridges, they'll be on the outside and not underneath. Just take your iron and clear them out, and you should have a working board. And if any of the pins didn't get solder, just put more paste on there and flow it again. You know, most of these chips you can reflow up to like 6 times. Some people say you can reflow them many times, but it all depends on the chip. So yeah, I can recommend this technique. So I hope it helps someone out there to get some boards done. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. If it'll ever come out. Hello? Where's pin one? I can't see it! Oh boy, you freaking did, you little hooker, you. I'll probably have to cut that out. Oh well. Turn around, I said. Why does something always go wrong? See what we're doing. I'm in a time of need, and that's, I don't know why. Get over here. This is going really well. Oh, why?